centering the voices of those who are most marginalized and those who are experiencing injustice. That is an equity, and that's also a justice strategy to say, we know we have excluded you as institutions. No matter how good intention we may have been, we are clear based on your outcomes that you are not included in these conversations. You are not included in the decision-making processes. And we're going to do a better job to think through when we have planning and program development, that it's not just that we're going to engage the community. It's like, how are we having equal stakeholders with those who live in our communities and are connected to the communities that we live? That to me is the basis of justice.
Everybody loves to tell their story. Everybody has a story. And I think people are flattered when you engage them. And, you know, with the understanding that, you know, their story is important, and it can help, you know, raise money to do this for more people. It can help bring attention to this issue, you know, whatever it is you need to do. You know, you're collaborating with them to get the word out about this great thing.
Like, we're all experts in some way. And I think sometimes there's a tendency to think of like community needs or community engagement as like not, there's a level of expertise that they are not bringing to the table. But what I've actually found is that community members themselves are like super experts in their own experiences and in their neighborhoods and their communities.
It is becoming more normative to even think about compensating people who are not professionals, but whose expertise we want to tap into. And that there is tension between wanting to get the information we need and limited budgeting to do that, but that whole conversation and how it relates to our values and the equity we wish to achieve is a good conversation to be having.
We need to recognize that we are doing our work in largely suboptimal conditions, less than ideal, much less than ideal, with new sources of stress and higher stakes. And the stakes of burnout are higher than they used to be. So we need to, you know, dream toward and organize toward the world that we want to live in, but we have to recognize the world that we're in.
Community partnership building takes a huge amount of time. And if you want to create sustainable community partnerships, you have to put in that time up front to figuring out where your priorities match, mm-hmm. and or whether you have insurmountable differences.
Recognizing the difference and the response from the community when you can be transparent with them, I think makes a great difference that sometimes may not be appreciated, especially when you have different agendas within the organization, and sometimes you may not want to let certain things out or spill out into the public. But just being as transparent as possible about what the plans are from beginning to end and how we're going to have it sustained and things like that, I think you get the best response from the community.
If we want to create a sense of belonging, we're the one, like those who have privilege and seats at the table are the ones who need to change, so that we can create a space that invites not just inclusion, but real belonging, but the understanding that we need each other to get to the place that's actually going to serve us all well.
Just being more aware of the fear associated with being as vulnerable to say, I need help feeding myself or my kids. I think that's a really important thing to pay attention to. And that there's a huge stigma involved in the fear around that, but also that some parents fear that they will lose their children if they try to get help because people will know their kids aren't eating. And so I think that is a good reminder for us to push for universal wherever it is and remove the stigma completely, where anybody who needs food gets it.
Imagine a socially connected community where people know and trust their neighbors and people from different neighborhoods, where they're motivated and supported through fair processes and practices to be civically engaged, where the structures, policies, and relationships connect residents to important services, resources, and inclusive spaces, and where people see themselves in the design art, options, and practices represented, and they feel welcomed in their community.